Good day everyone and welcome to my channel. In this video we'll look at how to troubleshoot an Eclipse IDE installation failure. Happens that you have trouble installing the Eclipse integrated development environment by using the Eclipse automatic installer and you get this error message that says installation failed with an error, show log, then you may want to try to solve this problem by manually installing Eclipse. In order to manually install it, which is a simple process, first we have to open the Eclipse web page and then download the zip archive packets. Let's go to the Eclipse website by entering www.eclipse.org. We click the link More after the page loads, which opens a drop-down menu, and then we click the link Download to download it. On the newly opened web page, instead of clicking on the orange button Download x86-64, we are going to click under that button on the text link Download Packages. We have to install Eclipse manually, so we need a zip package. On the following page, we do not use the option to download Eclipse executable installer, but we go to the Eclipse IDE package instead. Here on this page, we can see that we have options and links to download Eclipse for different development purposes. I assume that we want to install the Eclipse IDE for Java developers, and we want to install it on Windows machine. Here we have a link to download the zip archive of the Eclipse IDE 2021-03R packets. Let's click on that link, Windows x86-64, and then on the next page, click to download the zip file. We'll wait until the download of Eclipse, which is approximately 350 MB, is complete. After we get a zip file on our computer, we have to extract it, and then the Eclipse folder we are going to store somewhere on our disk. Going to put it inside the program files folder, then create a shortcut on the desktop. After running Eclipse for the first time, by double-clicking on the shortcut, we have to set the Eclipse workspace folder path. The workspace folder is the place where Eclipse puts all the source code files and projects. The suggested path here by Eclipse is c:\usr\rcm\eclipse\workspace, which is okay for me, and now I'll click the checkbox, use this as a default and do not ask again, because I don't want to see this pop-up window again. Finally, I'll press the Eclipse launch button. Now the Eclipse is starting. As you can see, everything is working perfectly just as we had hoped. The Eclipse IDE is launching as it should. I'm going to test further Eclipse functionality by creating the Hello World Java program. After creating a project, we open the Hello World project folder. I'll create a class file named Hello by right-clicking on the source file folder, and then I select the option to have the main method inside the class file. In between curly brackets of main method, let's type system.out.println. The easiest way to type this statement is to type sysout and then press Ctrl plus space. System.out.println is a statement that prints the argument passed to it. The println method displays results on the monitor. Let's enter some text in the print method and see if the result is displayed on the monitor. Now, let's click on the Run button, then click OK to save and launch the code. As we can see, we have printed text on the monitor. As a result, we can conclude that Eclipse is properly installed.
If you enjoyed the video, please subscribe and hit the bell icon if you'd like to see more helpful videos from us. Don't forget to comment in order to help us to improve our videos for you. Stay healthy. Stay fine.